This is a coin problem. Ed has 6 more quarters than dimes. The total value of his coins is $6.05. Find out how many of each coin Ed has. Well, of course you could guess, right? You can say, well, let's see, what if I've got, 6 more quarters than dimes. So let's say I've got 10 dimes, and let's say I had then 16 quarters, and you could just see how much each of these is worth. Well, if you had 10 dimes, then each dime's worth 10 cents, right? So you'd have to multiply each one by 10 cents, and then I'm gonna put this in cents, that would be 100 cents. And if you had 16 quarters, 16 in each one is worth 25 cents, and that ends up being 400 cents, and adding together, that would mean you've got 500 cents or $5. But the total value of his coins is $6.05. So for instance, this is not the correct answer. Well, we want to do this algebraically as opposed to just keep changing it. Like next I could try, how about 11 dimes and 17 quarters, or 12 dimes and, what's 6 more than that? 18 quarters, etc. So let's do this algebraically, but keep in mind that how many of each coin you have is different from how much it's worth. And I'm writing the worth in cents, but you could have done it in dollars and cents as well. So let's start again. Ed has 6 more quarters than dimes. I'm going to make up a chart for us to keep track of some information here. And we're going to define our variables right in the chart. So we're talking about two kinds of coins, right? So it's the type of coin. Well, we've got dimes and we've got quarters. All right. Now, what I'm going to do next is write what's called the unit value. In other words, how much is a dime worth? And I'm going to do everything in cents to avoid working with decimals. We know that each dime is worth 10 cents, and we know each quarter is worth 25 cents. So that's a given from what you know about the worth of dimes and quarters. Now, what we don't know is how many of each. So we could write how many, or you could write the word number, whatever is easiest for you. What do we know about the number of dimes and the number of quarters? Well, we know that Ed has 6 more quarters than dimes. So if I knew how many dimes there were, then I would add 6 to that number, and that'll tell me how many quarters. So the key here is that we want to define our single variable as dimes. How about D for dimes? Now, you can use an X or an N. I'm using D so I remember when I'm done. If I solve for D, that'll be the number of dimes. All right, so if I have D dimes and I have 6 more quarters than dimes, I've got D plus 6. That's how many. So far on my chart, I'm just keeping track how much each dime and quarter is worth, and then how many of each I'm going to use a variable. And the trick is the value. All right, so what this means is in money. Well, to get the value for 10 dimes, you would take 10 cents for each dime. So you're going to multiply the unit value times how many you have will give you the value of all the dimes. So in this first row, 10 times D will be just 10D. Now for the quarters, be careful here. You've got D plus 6 quarters. You've got to do 25 cents for each of those quarters, right? So you've got to do 25 times that whole quantity. So you're doing 25 times the entire amount, which is D plus 6. So 25, and you must put that in parentheses, D plus 6. Now, if you want, you could make a note here that the total value, sorry for that writing, the total value we know is $6.05, and I'm doing everything in cents. See how I did the unit value in cents? So this is 605. And what is true then is the total value of the dimes plus the total value of the quarters is the total value of all the coins. And that is the equation we want. Take the value of the dimes, 10d, that's the dimes, plus the value of the quarters, which is 25 times d plus 6, equals 605 cents. And that's the equation. All right, that's the hard part, getting the equation. The rest of it will be easy. And then we will go back and check our answer. So go ahead and put this on pause and solve it. I'm going to do it quickly here. We have 10d plus 25d. Now when I do 25 times 6, remember to distribute, you're going to get 150. Equals 605. And over on the left here, I can add the like terms, 10d plus 25d, and I'm also going to subtract 150 from both sides at the same time, so that I get 35d equals 455. And then I've got to divide both sides by 35. You can use a calculator or do this longhand. So we get d equals 13. Now, remember what d stood for? D stood for the number of dimes, right? And we know we had 6 more quarters, so d plus 6, that'll stand for the number of quarters. So now we're going to check our answer by making a little chart and see if this all makes sense. All right, so if we look at the chart again, we now know that d is 13, so I am going to put that in for the number of quarters. We know that for the number of dimes. So we have 13 dimes, 10 cents each, and I'm going to do this in real money. This is $1.30, right? Because you do 10 times 13. So the real value in dollars and cents would be the decimal points. You could keep it in all in cents as well if you'd like. Now, how many quarters? Remember there were 6 more quarters, so we've got 19 quarters. So we also need to figure out the value of the quarters, so you do 0.25 times 19, which is $4.75. And then to check it, it says it was 605. Actually add it up and see what you get, and you get 605, and that checks from the original problem, because the original problem, if we look back up, says that we've got the value of all the coins, $6.05. So here's the original problem. Ed has 6 more quarters than dimes. The total value is 605. And so here we are, when we checked it, we have 6 more quarters than dimes, right? And the total value is 605. So now we're ready to write the answer. It asked how many of each. It has 13 dimes and 19 quarters. If it just asked us for how many quarters, we would just say, oh, he has 19 quarters. If it asked just for the number of dimes, we would say we have 13 dimes. We have to remember we're going to answer the question from the original problem. And so this is how to do a coin problem. And of course, you could have kept this as just 10, 25, and not used any decimals, and the check still works the same. If you want, you can also do your check a little bit differently. You could say, I've got 13 quarters at 25 cents, and then just write 475. So you could say, okay, I'm checking out the quarters, I'm checking out the dimes, and then I had 19 quarters. $0.25 each was $4.75, and then I had 13 dimes, 10 cents each was $1.30, add it up. So you don't have to put it back in a chart, but you somehow want to, you know, go back and figure out the value of the dimes and the quarters from, you know, what you got for your variable D and check it out. So there's different ways to show your check at the end.